Okay, good day, guys. Today I'm going to be talking about something really close to me, not personally like that, but something I really like. I'm going to be talking about studying actuarial science. So I'll be giving you a breakdown, the good, the bad, and the ugly. And I'll give you two definitions of actuarial science so that you can explain to people what actuarial science is when you want to. Thank you. Peace. Okay, so we're going to chat about seven things that I like most about studying actuarial science and why. But first, let's chat about what actuarial science is real quick. What is actuarial science? So there are two ways of defining actuarial science or answering this question, actually. There's the ingredients method. For example, if someone asks you, what is bread? Then your answer can be, bread is a mixture of yeast, salt, sugar, oil, warm water, and flour all together. Bake. So when some people ask me what is actuarial science, and the answer I give them via the ingredients method is, it is a combination of mathematics, statistics, and finance with a pinch of economics, mixed in a blender, and then boiled at 1000 degrees Celsius, and it is best served at that degree. Excuse the pun. And the second way of answering this question, what is actuarial science, is to tell a person what the end result is. So, for example, if someone asks you what is bread, my answer will be, bread is something that you can eat. You can eat it dry with some peanut butter or chips or cheese or whatever, and you can make lots of fancy things with it. In a similar fashion, then actuarial science is a discipline that will allow you to work in insurance companies, asset management companies, banks, and also as a bonus, you will get to know how to calculate when people will die or not die, and you can also work in data analytics and a few other pertinent fields. Okay, now what I like most about actuarial science so far, at least, is one, the diversity of skills required to become an actuary. I mean, we have courses from the mathematics department, from accounting, from economics, from various, we even have professional communication, which is basically English, like on another level, actually, is actuarial management. So you need such a wide variety of skills, and then there are all courses that require you to have people skills, and you need to have worked this programming. I mean, it is so diverse, like you could literally finish first year with like great marks and stuff, and then secondly requires such different skills that you end up suffering. Now, that might not sound like such a nice thing, but it is nice if you don't like things that are always the same. If you like a challenge, you might find that nice, because now you have to figure out this new thing, and every year you have to kind of figure out how to get through the year, because it's not exactly the same as how it was last year. Okay, second thing is that actuarial science builds character. Oh my goodness, any moment of silence for that one. Actuarial science builds character, and it builds this from scratch. So whether you have character or not, that doesn't matter. When you get into actuarial science, they break, they crush you. And like, especially if you're doing it at least, I must add a disclaimer in this whole video that I am a UCT student, so maybe it's a bit different elsewhere, but you know, it's probably the same, because we are organized by some board that has that kind of sets everything and makes everything difficult. But yeah, so it builds characters, so you get beaten up a lot, and then you, if you're lucky enough, you rise from this dust and you come out stronger than ever before. If you are not, then I guess you, well, I mean, you rise in a different direction. Yeah, it's not funny. It's some people do better off even after walking away. So it's not a train smash. It's not for everyone. It's not even a cup of tea, like anything in this world. The third thing that I like about actuarial science is that when you tell people that you're studying actuarial science, people get really excited. They get so excited and they're like, wow. And a lot of them don't even know what the heck actuarial science is, so I hope they're watching this video. Because most of them get excited because they hear science and they think it's, ooh, science. But I mean, it's a science, yes, but it's not science like you might be thinking. This is money science, death science, statistical science. Thing number four, what I like about actuarial science is something I've really hinted at already just in this video, is that people don't know what actuarial science is. So help me, let's spread the word, let's share this video, let's get a lot of them to get a better idea of what actuarial science is. Number five, the actuarial science field is an understaffed field, if I can say that. So there is a high level of guarantee that, at least from when compared relative to when I started, when I think I'll finish, there's a high guarantee that there will still be jobs and there will be a lot of opportunities in the field for me to work and whoever started. Because of course there's such huge barriers to entry. For example, board exams are expensive, very few bursaries, and it's bloody difficult, I assure you. One of my lectures, I think Mario says we should say it's delicate. It's a very delicate course to study. Thing number six is I like competition, I like difficulty. So that's what I like about this course, because I think actuarial science is kind of like an extremely jealous and demanding girlfriend. Like, you literally can't have a life. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I've tried my best to have a life while doing this actuarial science thing, but it's been taxing, and you can also see the effect on my transcript that, oh yeah, Jonathan tried to pick up on some life. So yeah, it comes at a cost. I mean, especially because given that if you're probably in actuarial science, you probably like numbers like 80% and 90% and 100%, and those are a little bit hard to get in actuarial science if you have other things that you're doing. But nothing is impossible, right? Go and try. I think it's possible. One just needs to balance it and figure it out. So the last thing that I like about actuarial science is that there's a lot of respect that comes with being an actuary. I have a lot of respect for actuaries, of course, but there's a lot of things that come with a lot of respect that comes with, and prestige and fame and coolness and niceness. You get to walk in corporate offices and boss. Anyway, those are my favorite 7 things about actuarial science. Thank you for watching. If you're considering studying actuarial science, then feel free to ask me for advice in the comment section. If you wanted to just know what it actually is, then let me know in the comment section. If you now have a better understanding of what actuarial science is, even if not only minutely. So lastly, please do not, I urge you and I really plead with you to not forget to click subscribe and click on the bell. I mean, it's still free. Like, word on the street is that soon it's going to start costing people to subscribe to YouTube channels. So I'm looking out for your best interest. Anyway, thank you. See you next week.